Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, a tour of the ProPresenter 7 UI. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever looked at the user interface of ProPresenter and said, there's so much here, I don't know what goes where or why, go ahead, give me a like, thumbs up, and subscribe to this video if you haven't already. Subscribe to the channel, rather. So there is a lot going on within ProPresenter, and I acknowledge that I'm not the programmer. I'm just the biggest fan of Renewed Vision. So with that said, I thought that I would give you an overview because a few things have changed since ProPresenter 7 was introduced back in early 2020. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look at that. So, I want you to consider that basically everything within ProPresenter is organized into three columns. So, they're not equal columns. It's, you know, a little bit on the left, a lot in the middle, and a little bit more than on the left on the right. So, let's take a look at all that stuff. First off, we have libraries up here in the upper left-hand corner. Libraries are just a way to organize stuff. And when you do a search on stuff, then you will find the titles within all of your libraries. So I just keep things organized. You know, maybe this is the youth version of songs. This is for a regular contemporary worship service. I could have one for hymns. I could have one for sermons, etc. So you could do that. Someone was asking me one time, well, how can I add Bibles into my playlist? We'll talk about playlists and presentations here in a second. Without them going into my library? No, but you could have them go into a specific library that every once in a while you clean out everything in there. So absolutely a good way to organize stuff. So that's libraries. Next we have playlists. Playlists are like orders of worship. In the corporate world, we'd sometimes, you know, like it would be a medical conference and there'd be 10 doctors that were talking about various diseases, right? And so they'd all have their own PowerPoint presentations and we'd have 10 different instances of PowerPoint open on one computer, and then you had to go Command Tab or Alt Tab to go between them, and sometimes it was really annoying and showed up on the screen and all kinds of grossness. Well, in ProPresenter, you could have had all of those listed as one thing and just go very intuitively from one to another. That's what a playlist is. In the church world, it's the order of worship where you have maybe opening announcements and hymns and other music and a prayer and maybe some liturgy, an announcement time, maybe a video or two, the sermon, homily, whatever your church calls it, then maybe some closing worship, closing announcements, that kind of stuff. So that would be what is in a playlist. I've only got two items in this particular playlist, but if I go to this playlist, you'll see that I've got a few more, including an opening slide loop, a couple of songs, announcements, a sermon, a couple of other things that I added in just for fun there. Now, each of these items here is called a presentation. Personally, I think of a presentation as the whole shebang, but I think going back to my metaphor of having multiple instances of PowerPoint open, 12 doctors, 12 PowerPoints, 12 presentations. So each individual thing is a presentation, and you can put all of that into a playlist. So that's what is showing up here. Going down here, we have the media layer. Each of these are, again, organizational tools for you to show different pieces of media. But they also, they're called playlists because, and I've got a video on that, You can have them auto switch after a certain amount of time or after a video is done or what have you. So that's why we have these media playlists. They're not folders, they're actually playlists. And down here we have the video input layer, and it has all your currently active video inputs. By the way, if you see the question mark, that means ProPresenter can't find that. And that's because none of these things are connected right now. So that's why that's the case. Sometimes you'll see that here on the media layer, and that's because it's been moved from where ProPresenter was looking for it or deleted altogether. So you need to fix that. Now, up here, we have the slides area. This is where you're going to spend the vast majority of your time. So, you know, if it's a song, you go from one to another. I still have my key on from my lower third earlier. So you can see that. I'm going to go ahead and clear that out so that that's not showing things. And down under here, we have individual items in these media playlists. So you can interact with them there. Notice that we have this. This is the different transitions. How it moves from one slide to another is orange, and how it moves from one slide to another is this purplish color. Not one slide, one piece of media to another is a purplish color. I can change the size of these thumbnails down here by moving this slider. Farther to the left makes them smaller, farther to the right makes them bigger, and I could list them here or just use the regular thumbnails. Likewise, under the slides, I've got some of the same stuff, but I've got a couple of extra buttons. So that's the grid view, regular thumbnails. This is easy view. So if you come in and someone has clicked on that and you're like, well, where are the backgrounds that are going with the slides and all that? And this font looks different, but when it shows up on the screen, it looks normal. That's because this is easy view. This is for people like me with presbyopia, which is a fancy way of saying old people eyes. Bifocals. Yeah, I'm 48, almost 49, so bifocals. So this really helps in viewing stuff, and you can click on this button right here to change the font, how it looks in the preview in easy view mode, but it wouldn't affect how it goes out to the screen itself. So that's what that does. This is the list view, and I can click on this, and I was looking for that earlier, slides by group. So that will enable you to change how this looks as well. So this is kind of like half and half. It shows you what the slide looks like, and then it has the words that you can change so that it's easier to see. But you get a lot less of that on the screen than in the other views. So, oops, clear that out. So that's the second third. Oh, by the way, we do have the ability to do some fun stuff up here. Here, let me go back to this default view. And this can automatically advance stuff. This one is for notes, so I can add in slide notes. This is an arrangement, great for if you have one song that's sung in different arrangements, you know. One person sings verse 1, 2, and 3, and then the next week you have another worship leader that does verse 1, 2, 1, chorus 3, something weird. You can have multiple arrangements. We have a timeline here that can automatically advance stuff. If you're always going to sing it the same way, maybe you've got a background track, you could automatically advance it that way. And this enables you to change from the slides layer to the announcement layer. And then we can change the presentation on just this current, we can change the transition rather on just this current presentation and do that there. We can also change it on a per slide basis or a per piece of media basis if we wanted to as well. So a lot of flexibility here. Now here, sometimes I've said this is where you get the stuff, this is where you interact with the stuff, and this is where you preview the stuff, and that's what this is. Underneath here, I can switch between any of my screens. Right now I've got 6 added. ProPresenter can do at least 8 with the right computer. I have heard someone say that he was able to do 11, but I haven't verified that or checked which one. So I've been able to do 8. So there we go, and I can change which screen I'm previewing at a time, whether it's the audience screen, which is for the people in the congregation or the audience, and the stage screen, which is for the people that are leading. So I can watch those as previews down here. Right here, these are my clear buttons in layer order, bottom to top. There is an audio layer here. They could have just as easily put that on the bottom, since these are all visual clear buttons, and you know, wherever the audio goes, that would be from this audio playlist right here. Clear to logo. If you've got a logo set in ProPresenter preferences, you can clear that. And in some of the more recent versions of ProPresenter, you were able to not only have a clear all button, but other buttons. So I have this one, which clears everything but the announcements layer, which I'm using right here. So that's why I've created that one. Here we have a timeline. So as you're playing a video here, let me show a video. So as you're playing a video, yep. So see that? If I clear that, then you can see this going along here. And I've got controls where I can back it up 15 seconds. I could scoot forward 15 seconds or go 15 seconds from the end. In ProPresenter 7.10, I can add markers to do different things. And that's what these guys are right here. Pause or play. Now, that is the regular slides layer. If you want to watch the announcement layer, you'll notice that it's not actually doing anything at the same time. That's because this is a still image. It's not actually moving. It's actually a picture of my background here that I took. So, and there's the audio layer there. Now to interact with that audio layer, we can click here, and let me hide my thumbnail, and click here, and I can have a playlist, and within the playlist I could have multiple tracks. Then I also have the stage button, and this is where I can change the layout of my stage screen, or I could put in a stage message right there to tell people that are leading up front something. Then I have a timer. So this is actually where you create and start timers, but not where you display them. So you could have those display automatically on the stage screen, but depending on which layer that you put the timer on, it could be on the slides layer, or it could be on either of these next two layers that we talk about. Then you may or may not want to do that. Next, we have the messages layer. That's great for countdown timers, like I showed you right there. Also, if you need to send a message to the congregation, a lot of times for childcare purposes, little Johnny will need mommy or daddy, and so you could put up that message right there. Then we have the props layer. Props layer is super flexible. It can do a whole lot of stuff. And so people tend to use the props layer just as the default for whatever they need. And I want to challenge you not to do that, but to see if you can do it on another layer instead, because the props layer is so flexible that you might need it to do something that you were using it for doing something else, and then uh-oh, you're out of luck. So there's that. And then finally we have macros, which enable you to do multiple actions at once and then to save those. So that's kind of an overview of what's going on when it comes to the user interface in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Click on the fields there, give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free instead of charging you the normal $29 that course costs. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.